同学们好，今天我们来学习第129课 Lesson 129 70 miles an hour. We'll look at a story about a man who drives too fast. 一位男士车开得太快，结果被警察拦住了。好，一起来看课文，并且回答这样一个问题。What does Anne advise her husband to do next time? Anne 建议她的丈夫下一次做什么？
Look, Gary, that policeman's waving to you. He wants you to stop.
Where do you think you are? On a racetrack? You must have been driving at 70 miles an hour. I can't have been. I was doing 80 when I overtook you. Didn't you see the speed limit? I'm afraid I didn't, officer.I must have been dreaming.
He wasn't dreaming, officer. I was telling him to drive slowly.
That's why I didn't see the sign. Let me see your driving license. I won't charge you this time, but you'd better not do it again.
Thank you. I'll certainly be more careful.
I told you to drive slowly, Gary.
You always tell me to drive slowly, darling.
Well, next time, you'd better take my advice.
请大家回答这个问题。What does Anne advise her husband to do next time? To take her advice and drive slowly. Anne 建议她的丈夫下一次听从她的劝告，车开得慢一点。好，下面我们一起来看本课的关键词和词组，请跟我读。Keywords and expressions. Wave, 朝某人招手 wave to somebody. Track, mile. Overtake, speed limit. Dream, sign. Driving license, charge. 好，一起来看本课的主要语言点。警察拦住了 Gary 的车，问道。Where do you think you are? 你认为你现在是在哪儿呢? Do you think? 你认为是一个插入语。请大家注意 you are 的语序同一般的疑问句是不同的。来看两个例句。What do you think you're doing? 你认为你在做什么呢?这两个句子都有一点责备的意思。Which book do you think is more interesting? 你认为哪本书更有趣? Do you think?在这句话当中是用来征询意见的。On a racetrack 是在赛车道上吗？这是一种省略的说法，就相当于 Do you think you are on a racetrack? You must have been driving at 70 miles an hour. 你刚才一定是以每小时70英里的速度开车。Must have been 是对过去正在进行的事情的推测，可以翻译成一定是。准是在做某件事情。At 70 miles an hour, 以每小时70英里的速度。比如说 ,walk at 3 miles an hour, 以每小时3英里的速度行走。Fly at 900 kilometers an hour, 以每小时900公里的速度飞行。I can't have been, 意思是 I can't have been driving so fast.我不可能开得那样快。Can't have been 也是对过去正在进行的事情的一种推测，意思是不可能如何如何。I was doing 80 when I overtook you. 警察说，我是以每小时80英里的速度超过你的。Do 表示以某种速度行进。Overtake 意思是超车。比如说 ,Car overtook a truck.一辆小汽车超过了一辆卡车。Over 有超过的意思，比如说 overplay 打的或者踢的比某个人好。Overrun 超过某个限度。下面我们来看一组对过去正在进行的事情的推测。They can't have been doing their homework. 他们不可能在做作业。They must have been playing in the garden. 他们一定是在花园里玩。Didn't you see the speed limit? I'm afraid I didn't, officer. 你难道没有看到限速牌吗？恐怕没有，警官。The speed limit, 限速。A time limit, 时间限制。There's a limit to everything, 一切事情都有一个限度。Gary 说 I must have been dreaming, 我刚才思想一定在开小差。Must have been, 对刚才发生的事情的一种推测。但是 Ann 却说 He wasn't dreaming, officer. I was telling him to drive slowly. 警官，他刚才没有开小差。我刚才正告诉他开车要慢一点。Wasn't dreaming 和 was telling him 都是表示过去正在进行的动作，所以我们用了过去进行时。Tell somebody to do something. That's why I didn't see the sign.Gary 却抱怨起Ann来，说这就是为什么我没有看到那个标志牌。That's why, 这就是为什么，或者你还可以翻译成所以。再来看两个例句。That's how I got to the station. 我是这样到达车站的。That's what I told him. 我就告诉他了这些。这时候，警官请 Gary 出示一下他的驾驶证。Let me see your driving license. Driving license, 驾驶证。那么在美语里呢 ,see 要拼写成 s. Business license, 营业执照。I won't charge you this time. 这一次我就不罚款了。Charge, 在这句话的意思是罚款。但是 charge 还有其他的意思。比如说 ,How much do you charge for repairing the car? 修理这辆车你们收费多少？Charge, 收费。But you'd better not do it again. 但是你最好下次不要这么做了。Had better, 最好，后面加上动词的原形。如果说最好不要做某件事情，那么我们就在动词的原形前面加上 not。Gary 的态度很好，他说 I'll certainly be more careful. 我一定会多加注意的。Anne 说 Well,Next time, you'd better take my advice. 下一次你最好听我的劝告。Had better, 最好。Take my advice, 听我的劝告。我们还可以说 follow my advice. 如果你给别人建议或者劝告，那么就是 give advice. 来看一组含有 had better 或者 had better not 的句子。We'd better hurry, or we'll miss the train.我们最好快一点，否则就会误了火车。It's very hot. You'd better not go out without a hat. 外面很热，你最好不要不戴帽子就出门。本课中我们学习了如何表达对过去正在进行的动作的推测。一起来总结一下基本句型。Must have been. 那时一定是。Can't have been.那时不可能是。来看一组例句。You must have been driving at 70 miles an hour. 你刚才一定是以每小时70英里的速度开车。I can't have been driving so fast. 我不可能开得那么快。Must have been 以及 can't have been 看起来是完成时的形式，但是表达的却是对过去的某个时间正在进行的事情的推测。除此之外呢，Must have been 以及 can't have been 还可以表达对过去的状态或者情况的一种推测，二者的语气都非常的肯定。下面我们再来看一遍课文，请大家跟读，并且注意每个人是怎样对过去发生的事情进行推测的。
Look, Gary, that policeman's waving to you. He wants you to stop.
Where do you think you are?On a racetrack? You must have been driving at 70 miles an hour. I can't have been. I was doing 80 when I overtook you. Didn't you see the speed limit?
I'm afraid I didn't, officer. I must have been dreaming.
He wasn't dreaming, officer. I was telling him to drive slowly.
That's why I didn't see the sign.
Let me see your driving license. I won't charge you this time, but you'd better not do it again.
Thank you. I'll certainly be more careful.
I told you to drive slowly, Gary.
You always tell me to drive slowly, darling.
Well, next time, you'd better take my advice.
下面我们进入句型训练，来看看在不同的场景中如何对过去的状态或者过去正在进行的事情进行推测。Lesson 130. He can't have been. He must have been. Ill. Tired. He can't have been ill. He must have been tired. New. Old. It can't have been my new hat.It must have been my old one. Danish, Swedish. She can't have been Danish. She must have been Swedish. Dentist, doctor. He can't have been a dentist. He must have been a doctor. 40, 50. She can't have been 40. She must have been 50. 20th, 21st. It can't have been the 20th. It must have been the 21st. Youngest, oldest. He can't have been the youngest.He must have been the oldest. Reading, sleeping. He can't have been reading. He must have been sleeping. Dreaming, listening carefully. He couldn't answer the question. He can't have been listening carefully. He must have been dreaming.Working, sleeping. She didn't hear the phone. She can't have been working. She must have been sleeping. 我们通过两个教学单元学习了如何表达根据事实所做的推测。如果你想对现在的状态或者正在发生的事情进行推测，那么就可以用 can't be, 不可能是，或者 must be,一定是。如果你想对过去的状态或者是过去正在进行的动作进行推测，那么就用 can't have been, 那时不可能是，或者 must have been, 那时一定是。请大家注意，在这些结构当中 must 和 can 不再表达必须或者能够的意思。好了，今天的课就到这儿了。 Thank you and see you next time.